over all neurons. First neuron, here is a dog. First neuron of acoustic analyzer is located in this structure. It's inner surface of ductus cochlearis, and this structure is... Stop talking!
Guys.
And this structure is called corti organ, or organum spirale, or corti organ. There are receptor area of acoustic analyzer is present. Special receptor cells of acoustic analyzer, there are epithelial cells with villi on upper pole. This villi is contact with membrana tectoria in the lymphatic duct in ductus cochlearis. When liquid in perilymphatic space begin to fluctuate, this motion run to the endolymphatic space, to endolymph. Endolymph fluctuates together with membrana tectoria, and villi of receptor cells begin to flex. And during this flexion, nerve impulse are produced in special cells and then run to peripheral outgrowths of first neuron of acoustic analyzer. Body of first neuron is present in ganglion spirale. Ganglion spirale is located near the basis of spiral plate in cochlea and has the same shape as cochlea, 2.5 rings. This ganglion includes first body of first pseudo-unipolar neurons of acoustic analyzer. First, axons of this neuron run through canalis longitudinalis of medullus and run out from cochlea to meatus acousticus internus. This axon runs through meatus acousticus internus. Here these fibers run together with vestibular portion of nervus vestibular cochlearis. And this part of pathway is called nervus vestibular cochlearis, or eighth pair of cranial nerves. Then fibers run to rhomboid fossa, to the same side. In rhomboid fossa, these fibers contact with two nuclei. Nucleus cochlearis dorsalis and nucleus cochlearis ventralis. From nucleus cochlearis dorsalis, there are second neurons. Fibers run to the surface, or on the surface of rhomboid fossa up to midline, then run more deep in the space in the matter of pons, and run to opposite side and forms limniscus lateralis. Limniscus lateralis are fibers of acoustic pathway. There are axons of second neurons. These fibers run to thalamus of opposite side. Not to thalamus, to metathalamus. There are present third neuron. And then fibers of this third neuron run through posterior part of capsula interna, posterior portion, and forms radiatio acoustica. And then run to cortex of temporal gyrus, gyrus temporalis superior. There is passing of acoustic analyzer to cortex. Fibers which arises from ventral nuclei run more deep through matter of pons and has contact with nucleus superior of oliva. runs the same as all another. That's why pathway from ventral nuclei has more neurons than pathway from dorsal nuclei. And some fibers which run through midbrain run to nucleus calliculi inferioris. Nucleus calliculi inferioris are subcortical center of acoustic analyzing. Nucleus calliculus inferioris. Third neuron. Two variants. Some fibers run to nucleus. And some fibers run through nucleus to corpus geniculatum medialis. From this nuclei and nuclei calliculi superioris arises descending tract which is called tractus sectus spinalis. This tract runs to opposite side in midbrain, forms the decussatio tegmentalis dorsalis. Of spinal cord of opposite side. It's important moment. Acoustic analyzer connect by limniscus lateralis with opposite side of thalamus, opposite side of calliculus inferior, metathalamus and cortex. Next pathway is vestibular analyzer. Vestibular analyzer arises from receptor area increased ambularis of semicircular canals or receptor area of macula saculi et utricule. There are located epithelial cells with villi, the same as in acoustic analyzer. But villi of these cells is covered by gelatinous substance, which is called otolith membrane. This otolith membrane has higher inertia than all another liquid in inner ear. And when we begin to start, our organism with cells begin to start. Villi, which covered by gelatinous substances, don't move at the beginning. Our cells run, but villi is present on the same place. Where villi is less. Nerve impulse begin to form in the receptor cells. And receptor cells of all these macula connect with peripheral outgrowths of first neuron. First neuron of vestibular analyzer present on the bottom of meatus acousticus internus. And this ganglion is called ganglion vestibulari. First neuron. Then all this structure locates in meatus acousticus internus. Absence of first neuron run together with absence of acoustic analyzer to rhomboid fossa. But this absence contact with vestibular nuclei. Vestibular nuclei locates in lateral portion of rhomboid fossa, which is called area vestibularis. And there are four vestibular nuclei on each side. This vestibular nuclei has all names by fossa, but we may tell about dorsal, ventral, medial, lateral. From this nuclei, there are second neurons. Absence of second neurons of vestibular analyzer has different direction. Some fibers run to opposite side together with limniscus medialis. Contact with thalamus of opposite side. There will be third neuron. And run to cortex of temporal gyrus. And lower portion of postcentral gyrus, because vestibular analyzer has some small cortical areas in cortex of tennis cells. There are cortex direction pathway. Another variant, vestibular analyzer connects with cerebellum. With cerebellum, which controls our emotion, balance, and so on. That's why from the fibers of vestibular area, some axons of second neuron run to cerebellum. Through pedunculus cerebellaris inferior. There are tractus vestibula cerebellaris. Another variant. The same fibers must run downstairs up to spinal cord. These fibers run to the on the same side to spinal cord. One portion runs through lateral part, another portion of fibers runs through anterior funicle. This stretch is called tractus vestibular spinalis. And contact with motor nuclei of anterior horn on the same side. Then fibers from this nuclei run to muscles and control our balance. Next, some fibers connect with nuclei of oliva. Oliva is the nuclei of myelencephalon, and oliva has two types of nuclei. Upper nucleus is nuclei subcortical center of acoustic analyzer. Lower nuclei control balance, and there are nuclei of vestibular analyzer. That's why some fibers run to oliva. From oliva, fibers run downstairs to spinal cord 2 and form tractus oliva spinalis. Well, one to cortex, second to cerebellum, third to oliva, fourth to spinal cord, and vestibular analyzer connect with fibers which controls our opposite motion of eyeball and head to opposite side. This stretch is called fasciculus longitudinalis dorsalis. There are portion of reticular formation which connect nuclei of third, fourth, and sixth pair of cranial nerves, ocular motor, trochlear, and abducens with spinal cord. And this stretch controls our opposite motion of eyeball and head on opposite side. Vestibular analyzer contact with fasciculus longitudinalis dorsalis. There are main five pathways of vestibular analyzer. You have to describe all these pathways to next time with him, acoustic analyzer. You have to draw. Vestibular analyzer, you should draw. You may draw or not and describe orally or writing without it. But you have to know place of first neuron, place of second neuron, place of third neuron, to the same side or to opposite side. Do you understand your concept? Okay, goodbye.